I know from the beginning that the Mangus was very, very busy. And also I consider him like one of the best singers in the black metal world worldwide. George in the beginning was like, oh, Jim, come on, I don't have time. Maybe I will make one track, etc. I told him, please just give me the opportunity to send you the stuff, okay?
When I listened to the demo tracks, I said, fuck, oh, these songs can become great. And that's when I called him back and said, okay, man, I will do it fully, completely, because the music is great, it can become even greater.
Of course, there is a big connection with me and Roty Christ, as we started this band in 85, like Black Church in the beginning, and in 87 with Roty Christ. Some people think that I will make something, we will make all together the team, something like Thy Mighty Contract, Non Serviam, Tragic of the Lost Lovers. But I never have a purpose when I make music. Actually, I don't care what people will think. I just do whatever I have in my mind, in my heart.
Personally, I have traveled a lot of paths in the occult. I have searched in many aspects of it. Either pre-Christian or post-Christian ideas and philosophies. And I finally, in my age, I have come to realize some things and accept them as truths. Now I have a clearer idea of what is happening in the metaphysical level. I'm more convinced from my experience and my research.
For me, black metal, it's not a negativity, of course, okay? It's a mystic path. It's a secret way of life that helps you to be a better man for me, okay? It's not blasphemy. I'm totally into occult for sure, but I believe in positive things many years now. The Eutheria was the gift from Lucifer to Gabriel to burn down Sodom and Gomorrah.
It's an embodiment of darkness, but not darkness in the usual negative way. It's a Promethean figure, still strong, still fiery, still a warrior, but a priest also.
Exactly, it's a Luciferian light. Eutheria for me is something like freedom and justice. It's something like my personal avatar, my personal angel, my personal demon.
I never made music as my profession. Personally, I chose it this way because I wanted complete freedom and control in what I do. That's why I remained an amateur, that means a lover of the art, actually. It's true that nowadays, if someone wants to make a living out of music, it's not from the sales of the albums. Everybody knows it. It's from merch and live shows. If you want to choose music as your lifestyle, you have to do all this. At least you have to pay attention and offer quality products. I'm always careful to offer some good quality in what you do.
I'm very satisfied because I do what I love most and I can live from it. Of course, I have to try very hard because all the times I have to offer something to the people.
Something good.
Something good.
That's important. The something good to the people.
The quality is very important, yes.
I'm not a fan of the live shows myself. I don't enjoy much a live of a black metal band because I think black metal for me is music that should be experienced alone and not collectively. But it's not only this. I cannot follow the band due to my other occupations, work and family, in big tours. If they go for 60 days, it's impossible. Even 2 weeks is almost impossible for me. And I said, okay, if you decide to take the band live, we have to find a singer for the live shows.
The singer will be Morian. Florian Magnus is also the singer of Dark Fortress and Alkaloid. Also, he is an opera singer. I think for the next 3 years, we will play all over the world.